Let us pray. Be present to your family, O Lord, we pray, and graciously ensure that those you have endowed with the grace of faith and an eternal share in the resurrection of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. And let us listen to the reading now from the Word of God, from the Acts of the Apostles.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. There broke out a severe persecution of the church in Jerusalem, and all were scattered throughout the countryside of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. Devout men buried Stephen and made a loud lament over him. Saul, meanwhile, was trying to destroy the church. Entering house after house and dragging out men and women, he handed them over for imprisonment. Now those who had been scattered went about preaching the word. Thus Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip, when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed and crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial song is, "Let all the earth cry out to God with joy."
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Shout joyfully to God, all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all on earth worship and sing praise to you. Sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the people, the children of Adam.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
He has changed the sea into dry land. Through the river they passed on foot. Therefore, let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. But I told you that although you have seen me, you do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should lose nothing of what he has given to me, but that I should raise it up on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So we have come into the eighth chapter of the Acts of the Apostles, and some very interesting dynamics. There's great persecution taking place in Jerusalem and the surrounding area, and we've heard of the persecution of Stephen, and that set a real terror among the fledgling Christian community. They were terrified for themselves. And for St. Luke, it begins a new era in the Christian experience, that the message of God is not going to be interrupted even by persecution. The apostles, for the most part, stay in Jerusalem and are still preaching, but But some of their disciples are moving out. Philip moves to Samaria and begins to preach the good news. What an interesting thing that he moves to Samaria. Because the Samaritans, who were despised by the Jews essentially, they still believed that they were a central part of the history of faith, the history of the religion in Israel. And in fact, they would have viewed the Jews as being the wayward ones, the ones who moved away from central belief. And they had a belief also in the Messiah. We remember from the story in John's Gospel, chapter 4, the Samaritan woman at the well. And so it is a kind of a proclamation that the good news is for all people. And there is no persecution or death or destruction or anything else that will disrupt the plan of God, which is the proclamation of the good news. And that is precisely what Jesus was saying in the gospel. He's saying, I have come down from heaven to accomplish a purpose, and I will not return empty-handed to the Father. And the purpose is that the good news be proclaimed to all. And so in these days of persecution with the coronavirus, what a great message that is. That God will not fail to proclaim the good news and to proclaim the central message, which is the presence of Jesus, that he has come to give us life. He is the bread of life, and we are fed and nurtured in him. So let us turn to him in prayer now. We ask you, Lord, to hear our prayers this afternoon as we come together in your name. We ask you to bless us. Continue the work of renewing us during this pandemic. We pray to you, Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray to you for all who are confined in their homes at this time and finding life difficult and challenging, and having worry and anxiety about what the future holds and how we will proceed. We ask you to alleviate those worries and anxieties and just bless us with your peace. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear
us. Hear our prayer. We pray to you for all who are sick at these times. We pray especially for Martha Catherwood, who is suffering with the coronavirus. And Darcy
Masters.
Huh? Darcy Masters. We ask you, Lord, to bless all others who are suffering, who are being in contact with the dreaded disease. We ask you to be with them. Bless them with your abundance. At this time, we pray to you. We pray to you for all who have died in the hope of rising again. We pray especially in this Mass for our brother Vince Grafe, who just died recently, and for Al Holman, who formerly lived here before moving away to be with his sons. We ask you, Lord, to receive them both into the eternal peace of your kingdom. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our own needs and intentions that we present now from depths of our own hearts, we pray to you, Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread we offer you, the work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of ours may be acceptable to God, who is our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, by rising he has restored our life. And so with all of the angels and saints, we proclaim your glory as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all of your people. And remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Apostles, and with all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, O Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now let us pray for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await in blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Mm-hmm. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Mm-hmm. Thank you, and let us share his peace now with each other, with those who are around us, acknowledging that he desired for us to have his peace. It is his first gift to the disciples after the resurrection. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Mass is ended. We go now in peace to love and serve God and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for joining us. And now we will proceed with the Holy Hour, virtual adoration. We hope you can stay with us and be blessed by spending that time.
complain about them.
Maybe today you're reflecting on the 23rd Psalm. We'll break it up. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. Is the Lord my shepherd, the one I follow? Or do I sometimes try to take the lead? Psalm says, I shall not want, but I do have wants, I have longings, I have needs. Do my wants match my needs? Do they match what he wants for me? How often do I allow him to lead me to those restful waters that my soul may be refreshed by him?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Continue to reflect on the 23rd Psalm. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. With your rod and your staff, but give me courage. Do I follow God's lead for his name's sake? Do I trust his way is the right path? As I walk through this dark valley of the pandemic, am I afraid and focus on my fears? Or do I walk as one who has God at my side with the kind of courage that only He can give?
Thank you.
Continuing our reflection on the 23rd Psalm, you spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. What do I see before me? When in the sight of this enemy, this virus, do I see a table set by him that invites me beyond? O Lord, that I may trust you, that you have spread the table before me indeed, especially the Eucharistic table. May I know that you anoint my head with oil, and may I see my cup as overflowing and not lacking in any way.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Continue our reflection on the 23rd Psalm, final period. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. What follows me these days? Is it goodness and kindness? Goodness and kindness that others see in me? Or does my mood change dramatically in the midst of difficulties? May we live and dwell in your house, O Lord, whether we are actually here in this house or whether that house is in us. These days and for years to come, may we live in you and you in us.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Jesus, our risen God, our risen Christ, we thank you for this opportunity of being in your presence and spending time in you. We thank you for the peace you extend to us during this pandemic, during this time of fear and worry and doubt and not knowing what to say or what to do. We thank you for your presence. You've always guided your people through these difficult times. We trust you will continue the work of guiding us through this. We ask you to bless us now as we depart from your presence. I want to thank you for joining us again for Eucharist and for a virtual holy hour. Please continue to stay in touch with us through the website And we will update you on everything that is going on, and you're invited to participate in many things. You send us your greetings as we have asked. You've noticed some additional people have been sending them in, so please join in as family to send those greetings. Have a wonderful afternoon.